We have the Josh and Dr. Brent joining us from their farm and the Mercantile up in New York. So anyway, we will do that later. Marlo, in case you didn't know, or Marla, we are going to do this as a little bit of an encore presentation because we only have about 5 minutes left. If you missed it, it's a fabulous new poncho. It is a birthday surprise piece, and it is $59.76. This is going to be your shell pink. Here's that great sand. Then we have the cloud color, and then finally we have black. Already half the quantity gone. I have extra small through 3X. So Marla, if you don't mind really quickly, can you kind of walk us through this once more?
I can, and I just changed colors because I wanted you to see how gorgeous the sand is with a black pant. I think it's so elegant, little gold jewelry. It's fabulous. Bottom line is, I don't have a tank on now, just me. And this is so light and so cool and so airy and so easy. And yet there is something very glamorous about it because of this border, right? The border is actually chiffon, so it's inset with chiffon. Believe it or not, that's a lot of work. Think about what we had to do to make this piece. When you look at it, and we've talked about this before, my pieces are not the least expensive here on HSN, but when you look at something like this, do you realize how beautiful, if you look at the, do you see that there's no mitered seam here? So we literally cut this piece, so we had to cut this outer piece. All of this had to be sewn together, and then the top piece sewn into it, and you can't make a single mistake, because if you do, all of a sudden the symmetry and the elegance of it is completely blown. So it takes a great deal of time to do a piece like this. If I hadn't put this little strip in it, my manufacturer said, gee, Marla, you know, we could do this a lot less expensive if you didn't put the strip in it. And I just gave a withering look because it was like, yeah, okay, fine, but that's not what I want to do. So sew away, please. And they did. They did a beautiful job with it. It's a very difficult piece to sew. Mm-hmm. For any of you who do sew, you can imagine to get those, that sewing, that exacting, so that you get this very just clean, simple elegance.
Well, and Marla, I'm going to show them one other thing too. Guys, the other thing that's crazy is chiffon is so hard to sew and work with. If you ever try to sew with chiffon, it tends to bunch and it gets all stringy and bad looking. Look at how fine that little hem is. Just almost like a scarf hem. Look at how delicate that is. And again, that really goes back to the quality that Marla brings you. I think it's so important. We've said it many times. It's not the least expensive line here at HSN, but it's worth every last penny because the quality is there. And Marla, it reeks rich. You know what I mean? If it was a bad chiffon, it looked all bunchy and was all kind of a hot mess, it would not look as refined and truly as expensive as it looks.
But that's the thing, Suzanne, with almost everything I do. It's really funny. When I was looking for manufacturers for this line, you'd think like, okay, big deal, get some sewing machines and sew. No, it's the finishing work. Because when you're using fabrics like chiffon or this crepe or these light, flowy fabrics that I like, it's all about the sewing. If these aren't beautifully sewn, you know, when then it is, you know, to go with our schlepping and schlumping tonight, it looks like a schmata, okay? You have to sew these things beautifully to make them be something, to elevate them.
Yes.
You know, the difference between when we talk about like fast fashion and couture, right? You know, everybody knocks off a Chanel jacket. Why isn't it a Chanel jacket? Because of the sewing, because of the finish, because of the quality of the fabric. So whatever fabrics we choose, we do the best in class of our fabrications that we use. When we sew, we go into best in class factories. I went to China last year. I was there over Thanksgiving last year. And I went into the factories to see where my things are made, what kinds of conditions are they in. I was so proud of the factories we're in and the handwork that these people do. Unbelievable. And the same thing with our pieces made here in New York.
Yeah, you can see it, you'll feel it, you can tell it. You look like a rich girl when you're wearing it. That's what counts. Okay,
well,
Marla, I gotta say
I'm
goodbye.
I'm gonna see you guys from college.